It was first discovered, first diagnosed in 1981 by Joel D. Weissman and in a homosexual in San Francisco, USA. In 1983, it was named as a lymphadenopathy associated virus, as the first symptom is flu-like. It caused flu-like symptoms and lymphadenopathy. In 1984, it was mentioned as a human T-cell lymphotropic virus, as it affects the T-cells mostly. In 1986, the International Committee of Viral Taxonomy named it as an immunodeficiency virus. Coming to the history in India, in 1986, first case in India was diagnosed. In 1987, first antiviral drug was introduced, that is azithromycin. In 1918, compulsory testing of blood for HIV was done. In 1995 onwards, so there was a highly active antiretroviral therapy, that is heart therapy. Even though it was diagnosed from 40 years back, still it is a hazard to humankind because its major mode of transmission is sexual, as sex is a basic need for everyone. And there was mother to child transmission, and the disease is of a long incubation period. And disease has its long incubation period where the patient do not have any symptoms, so he will not come to the hospital for general checkups. And cure, only HIV has no cure till today, but what we achieve is remission, and we increase the duration of the life expectancy. And prevention depends upon the self-protective sexual behavior code, and one which protects others. It is very challenging to human behavior, and preventive vaccine is also not available. Coming to the stats about HIV/AIDS, global-wise, adults and children living with HIV are 35.3 million, and AIDS-related death among adults and children in 2001, it is 1.8 million. Now it came down to 1.6 million. The more prevalence is in the age, more prevalence of HIV is between the 15 to 49 years of age. Coming to the stats in India, according to the 2011 census, there was about 20.9 lakh people living with HIV. HIV infection in age group of 15 to 49 is 86% of all infections, and HIV infection in women is up 39% of all infections. AIDS-related deaths are 1.48 lakh. Coming to the actual topic proper, human deficiency virus belongs to the family of retroviridae, genus lentivirus. Lentivirus are the slow viruses with a long incubation period. What is retrovirus? Actually, DNA will transcripts into RNA, but in this case, RNA will be transcripted into DNA with the help of enzyme reverse transcriptase, and it's called as retrovirus. Origin of HIV, first it was discovered in Africa in a chimpanzee, where they used to hunt the animals. They accidentally come in contact with the infected blood, and so it started infected humans. Over decades, the virus has slowly spread across from Africa and later into other parts of the world. Coming to the structure of HIV, HIV is an enveloped virus with an outer protein core of GP120, which helps in attachment to the CD4 cells, and transmembrane protein GP41. And the nucleic acids are surrounded by the nucleic protein capsid shell, which is P24 antigen, which helps in diagnosis. It consists of two positive sense strands of RNA molecules, and along with it is integrase and polymerase enzymes. There are two types of HIV. HIV 1 is the major cause of disease of the world. Whenever you talk about the HIV, we only consider about the HIV 1. HIV 2 is not so prominent. It follows the slow growth. It mainly seen in the West Africa only. HIV 1 is divided into 11 subtypes A to K, where C is the most prevalent in India, and D is more prevalent in intravenous drug users. Coming to the HIV entry and pathogenesis of HIV, initially with the help of GP41 and GP120, it will bind to the CD4 cells. CD4 cells with the help of the core receptor CCR5 and CXCR4. In some conditions like homozygous or heterozygous mutations, there will be loss of CCR5 and CXCR4. In that case, the people are not infected with HIV. after binding receptor binding to the CD4 receptors and CCR4 and CXCR4, there will be uncoating and release of RNA molecules. The RNA molecules is transcribed into the DNA with the help of reverse transcriptase. DNA will be integrated into the host DNA. The host DNA is under the control of virus, and there will be transcription of viral RNA and the translation of viral proteins, and there will be assembly of viral proteins, and there will be synthesis of virus. With the help of budding, they will be released into the outside. Coming to the peculiarities of HIV, it is a heterogeneous and a genetically diverse in variety of biological, serological, molecular features. Predominantly lymphotropic, it will bind to CD4 cells. Incurability, most important characteristics is persistent sanctuary or reservoir cells, majority of them being the resting CD4 T cells, which have long half-life and are unaffected by the antiviral therapy. As these are quiescent cells, and our antiretroviral therapy cannot reach that cell, and the viral will be present in that memory cell for quite long. It infects the CD4 cells, which are the main cells for the humoral immunity as well as the cell-mediated immunity, so that our body immune response is also decreased. Whenever there is a replication in HIV, there are many mutations will occur every time the new species will occur in a single cycle. So hence drug resistance, and this leads to difficulty in preparation of vaccine. Body fluids containing HIV are blood, semen, vaginal and cervical secretion, breast milk, amniotic fluid, cerebrospinal fluid, pleural, pericardial and peritoneal fluids, and any body fluid contaminated with blood. Following body fluids do not contain HIV are saliva, tears, sweat. So previously, it was advertised that kissing do not cause HIV. Modes of transmission, we all know. Most important mode of transmission is by sexual. In worldwide, heterosexual, where it is American, it is a homosexual transmission. Through blood, nowadays, through blood transmission is very much low, as the compulsory testing is done. Parent to child transmission is also decreased nowadays with the help of heart therapy, which was introduced immediately after the diagnosis, and routine antenatal care usually tests for HIV. Coming to the dynamics of sexual transmission, male to female transmission is 5 to 6 times higher because the female vaginal surface area is more, and the epithelium which favors the virus. Whether from female to male contact is low, as a very short time contact of a penis, and also very low surface area. Reproductive tract infection is common in women. Whenever there is some STD infection, it helps to HIV to easily to enter, as there is a breach in the epithelium. Receptive anal intercourse, as rectal mucosa is very fragile when compared to the vaginal mucosa, when there was anal intercourse, there was more chance of HIV transmission. Hello. Hello, I am Adipul. Hello. ஹலோ
சுமந்த் ஆடிபிள்
ஓகே மேம் கம்மிங் டு த ரூட்ஸ் ஆஃப் அக்விஷன் ஆஃப் HIV இன் இந்தியா த மோஸ்ட் காமன் மோட் ஆஃப் ட்ரான்ஸ்மிஷன் இஸ் ஹெட்ரோசெக்சுவல் ஃபாலோட் பை த அன்னோன் காசஸ் அண்ட் நவேடேஸ் அஸ் ஐ ஆல்ரெடி டோல்ட் பேரண்ட் டு சைல்ட் ட்ரான்ஸ்மிஷன் இஸ் டிக்ரீசிங் பிளட் அண்ட் பிளட் ப்ரோட்ஸ் ஆல்சோ டிக்ரீசிங் in India when compared to the other world, homosexuals are also rare. Most efficiency route of transmission, whenever there is a blood transfusion infected with HIV, there will be an efficiency of 90% to 95%, followed by the anogenital sex, which is of 30%, IV drug abusers of 0.67%, and a needle stick exposure is just of 0.3%, and mucous membranes flash to eye, boronasal areas are 0.09%. Coming to the immunopathogenesis, The virus mainly affect the markers containing the CD4 cells, as the CD4 cells are important in the both humoral and the cell-mediated immunity. It leads to the immunosuppression and leads to an increase of opportunistic infections. Our normal immunity will suppress these infections. Whenever there is only immunosuppression, so these organisms will proliferate and cause the disease, hence they are called as an opportunistic infection. The cells bearing CD4 receptors are skin, Langerhans cells, fibroblasts, megakaryocytes, basophils, neuronal cells, hematopoietic cells, and other cells. These are the cells that containing CD4 receptors. Coming to the natural history of disease, initially in the first 4 to 8 weeks, there was a peak in the HIV RNA copies, because of there was no immunity initially. After 3 weeks, there was maintained up to plateau phase up to 12 years. Thereafter, there was a decrease in CD4 cell count and lead to the HIV stage, and leads to the AIDS infection. Window period is the time gap between the entry of virus and the seroconversion. It takes 4 to 8 weeks. In this time, if we test also, there was no antibodies or antigens to detect. In this time, we can detect only with the help of a PCR. After 12 weeks, we can detect the antigen antibodies. This is a graph showing the HIV growth and also the fall in the CD4 molecules. And there was maintenance of latency of about 10 years. Initially, and later onwards, there was a high peak of transmission. In between, during latency, there was a spread to others is also very low. Coming to the stages of infection, clinical stage where CD4 count is more than 500, the features are asymptomatic and persistent generalized lymphadenopathy. In clinical stage 2, where CD4 count is 200 to 500, unexplained weight loss and herpes zoster. Clinical stage below 200, unexplained weight loss, diarrhea, fever. However, clinical stage less than 50, there will be increase in 8 defining illness like usophageal candidiasis, cryptococcosis, and many isospora belli, cryptosporidiosis, and many opportunistic infections and Kaposi's sarcoma like malignancies. Coming to the primary HIV infection, it has already showed there was a peak initially of the first 2 to 4 weeks, which there was no immunity initially. In this, just flu-like symptoms where patient lymphadenopathy, pharyngitis, maculopapular rash, orogenital ulcers. Sometimes due to rapid proliferation, it may even lead to the meningoencephalitis. In stage 1 asymptomatic, there was some persistent generalized lymphadenopathy. In stage 2, there was a mild symptoms, but there were increase of skin conditions like herpes zoster, papular pruritic eruptions, and seborrheic dermatitis. In clinical stage 3, there was advanced symptoms. There was unexplained persistent fever of unknown origin, persistent oral candidiasis, oral hairy leukoplakia, primary tuberculosis which present in any stage, acute necrotizing ulcerative stomatitis, gingivitis, and periodontitis. In clinical stage 4, which is also called AIDS, HIV, it's called HIV wasting syndrome. Here, where the AIDS-defining illness or opportunistic infections will occur, in this, the CD4 count is less than 50. The infections like pneumocystis, pneumonia, recurrent severe bacterial pneumonia, Kaposi's sarcoma, cytomegalovirus, and central nervous system toxoplasma. Coming to the opportunistic infections, actually these organisms will not be pathogenic, but due to the decrease in immune system, they lead to the contaminants and cause their disease. HIV-related infections are they may be bacterial, viral, fungal, or protozoal. Coming to the bacterial, it may be tuberculosis, syphilis affecting the CNS, GIT infections or salmonella infections, lung tuberculosis, bacterial respiratory infections, and typical mycobacterial immune complex. Mucocutaneous infections are bacillary angiomatosis and pyoderma in children. Coming to the viral, cytomegalovirus pneumonia, mucocutaneous or herpes simplex virus, oral hairy leukoplakia, molluscum virus, human papilloma virus infection. Coming to the fungal cryptococcosis, in lung, pneumocystis, gyrations, pneumocystis, pneumonia, mycocutaneous candidiasis, and other pencillus. Protozoal, coming to the protozoal. coming to the protozoal, there was increased risk of toxoplasmosis in a GIT, which is a cause for the persistent diarrhea, rhizosporosis, entamoeba scolytica, strongyloides, giardiasis. Other illness are AIDS dementia complex and progressive multifocal leukoencephalopathy. As mucocutaneous, there was increase in non-Hodgkin's lymphoma and there was increase in HPV infections, which leads to the invasive cervical cancer. This is the table, this is the graph showing whenever there is a fall in CD4 count less than 50, there was an increase of atypical infections and opportunistic infections. Initially, there was herpes zoster when there was good CD4 count, and later it was oral candidiasis. When it falls below less than 50, there was an opportunistic infection like cryptosporidiosis and progressive multifocal leukoencephalopathy. In any stage, TB can occur into any CD4 count. Coming to the mucocutaneous manifestation, skin is the most commonly affected organ in patients with HIV. More than 90% of HIV-infected patients developing mucocutaneous signs and symptoms. Skin manifestations have diagnostic and prognostic values with the different viral load, and CD4 manifestations occur. With the help of skin manifestations, we can diagnose the stage of the disease. If there is something like AIDS defining illness, we can call it as a severe disease. If there are only herpes zoster like infection, we can call it is only there present in the mild disease. Skin is the most common because of a lot of CD4 receptor bearing cells like Langerhans cells and fibroblasts are present in the skin. Coming to the classification of mucocutaneous manifestation, there may be infectious, non-infectious, specific mucosal manifestations, nail and hair infections, cutaneous adverse reaction due to antiretroviral therapy like morbillifer rash, urticaria, angioedema, Stevens-Johnson syndrome, toxic epidermal necrolysis. Coming to the infections that are common in HIV, are acute viral infections are acute exanthema of HIV. There was an increase in herpes simplex virus, varicella zoster virus, Epstein-Barr virus, human papilloma virus, gained condyloma accumulata will be present. Molluscum contagiosum, these are seen as an atypical infection where normally seen as a small papules in this condition, in the HIV condition, they will be seen as a gained papules and disseminated. Bacterial infections, staph aureus infections, mycobacterial infections, fungal infection, there was atypical dermatophytosis. Candidiasis is the most common infection in immunosuppressed patients. And there was increase in seborrheic dermatitis due to malassezia, furfur, and trichosporiosis. And there was increase in parasitic infections like scabies, that is a Norwegian scabies, which is common in HIV patients. And protozoal infections like pneumocystis pneumonia and toxoplasmosis and leishmaniasis. Non-infectious manifestations are dryness and eczema, psoriasis, papular pruritic eruptions, pigmentary disorders, neoplasms like Kaposi's sarcoma, cutaneous adverse reactions to drugs. Specific mucosal manifestations which are diagnostic for HIV are oral hairy leukoplakia, disseminated herpes simplex virus infections, disseminated herpes zoster virus infections, human papilloma virus, and fungal infections are oral candidiasis. Malignancies are Kaposi, sarcoma, non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. These are called as an AIDS-defining illness. Whenever there is present of this AIDS-defining illness, we can estimate it as a poor prognosis, and we can estimate the CD4 count as less than 200 or less than 50. Coming to the nail manifestations, these are atypical manifestations. Like melanotic bands, maybe dark pigmentation to the drug of gedovidin, yellow discoloration. And hair manifestations, like as infection is a stressful condition, it leads to alopecia, male pattern alopecia, premature graying of hair, long eyelashes. Coming to the individual infections, herpes simplex is one of the most common opportunistic infection in HIV patients. In addition to whenever there was presence of HIV and HSV double trouble, there was increase of transmission and there was increase of viral shedding of HIV, which will increase the transmission risk of HIV. There was an increase in twofold risk of HIV acquisition in patients having genital herpes. Coming to the clinical features, chronic herpetic ulcers of more than 1 month duration is an AIDS-defining condition. Tender, often painful, and gained ulcerative lesions of genital region, perianal area, and lip are hallmark of HSV in HIV infected patients. As I already told, the lesions are atypical, which are gained and which are chronic in nature, which are whenever there is STD in chronic, which whenever there is a presentation of STD in a chronic condition, we have to think of HIV in this patient. Our treatment is early administration of 400 milligrams acyclovir or maybe famciclovir 253 milligrams thrice a day. The picture showing a hemorrhagic crusting of extensive herpes labialis, and this is showing gained ulcer of a pre and post treatment of herpes genitalis. Herpes zoster in HIV, we already know, whenever there is a HIV, there was a multidermatomal involvement, there was hemorrhagic disseminated, and a very large bulla are present. Some cases develop herpes zoster ophthalmicus. In this condition, treatment is oral acyclovir 800 milligrams 5 times a day. Alternatively, famciclovir can be or else valcyclovir of 1 gram thrice a day can be given. Coming to the molluscum contagion, like other infection, it also present as numerous widespread nodular gain molluscum and disfiguring. Extragenital gained mollusca are marker of HIV. Treatment is ART is very effective for treatment in addition to the conventional methods like cryotherapy, electrodesiccation, genital curettage, etc. For resistant cases, topical imiquimod 5% and topical or intravenous cedofovir can be used. Coming to the Kaposi sarcoma, the etiology is HHV-8. It may be transmitted sexually or probably more by the fecal-oral route. The clinical lesions are purple patch, block, or nodule, which may ulcerate. Aggressive course in HIV, especially among homosexuals with an average of 20 to 40 years. The response of a Kaposi sarcoma to ART is unpredictable. Specific local or systemic therapy is often instituted as well. The picture showing purplish blocks all over the body, which is a diagnostic of Kaposi sarcoma. Human papilloma virus, it may present as a gained condyloma accumulator. Whenever there was infections with the serotypes of HPV 16 and 18 will lead to the carcinoma in situ and high-grade dysplasia, which will lead to the invasive cervical cancer. Invasive, as already mentioned in the previous table, invasive cervical cancer is also an age-defining illness. Treatment, topical imiquimod of 5%, podophyllotoxin of 25%, liquid nitrogen. Cedofovir can be used in anogenital warts, and ART can lead to decreased size. Oral HPV can be treated with 1 to 3% cedofovir solution. Preventive vaccine for HIV-related carcinoma, recombinant quadrivalent vaccine, bivalent vaccine are available. But there was controversy. There is an immunosuppressive state. We can't give the vaccine or not. The picture showing the giant condyloma accumulator, and another picture showing the oral hairy leukoplakia caused by the Epstein-Barr virus. Coming to the bacterial infections, so staph infections, mycobacterial infection, bacterial angiomatosis, syphilis infection, and others. Staph aureus is the most common infection, not only in HIV in general. It causes the bullous impetigo, eczema, folliculitis, which is of recurrent and furuncles, carbuncles, cellulitis, and hydrocephalus. Coming to the bacterial angiomatosis, is caused by the Bartonella hansli and Bartonella quintana. It is a vascular proliferative response to infection. Clinical features are solitary, small red purple pinpoint sized papules that increase in size from nodules to tumor. Histology, the special strain used for bacterial angiomatosis is Fordin silver strain. Drug of choice is erythromycin, 500 milligrams, 4 times a day, given for 3 to 4 weeks. Coming to the cutaneous tuberculosis, whenever there was HIV infection, there was more chances to increase of TB as there was a decrease in the cell-mediated immunity. The diverse clinical presentations are scrofula, keratotic papules, and nodules, tuberculosis. Clinical appearance is not always characteristic. The response to ATT is confirmatory. Always suspect whenever there is a non-healing cutaneous ulcer which is not responding to antibacterial or antiviral, we can suspect HIV. This is a picture showing TB lymph nodes and tubercular ulcer which is of non-healing. Into the fungal candidiasis, oropharyngeal candidiasis is the most frequent opportunistic fungal infection, infecting the more than 90% of the HIV patients. Clinical features, candidiasis may be oropharyngeal, esophageal, or vulvovaginal. Esophageal candidiasis is called as an age-defining illness. Clinical features, cottage is like creamy white exudate flocks on tongue, which can be easily removed and leaves an inflammatory erythematous surface. Treatment is fluconazole 100 mg daily for 14 days. The picture showing a cottage is like creamy white exudate flocks on the tongue. Another picture showing endoscopy picture showing the esophageal candidiasis. Dermatophytosis, they occur like an atypical infection without a central clearing. Treatment is topical systemic antifungal therapy with the imidazoles and triazoles. Coming to the parasitic infections, as there was an itching is suppressed and there was immunity suppression, there will be increase of worms up to more than 1 million, which causes the crusted scabies. We can use scabiesides like 5% permethrin. In this case, we have to use it for a long duration when compared to the conventional therapy where we use it once a week or twice. In this condition, oral ivermectin has given up to continuous dose up to 3 months. Coming to the non-infectious dermatosis, maybe eosinophilic folliculitis, whether it's follicular stuff, folliculitis, papular transient, there may be papular transient 4 to 6 weeks or maybe chronic more than 6 weeks. Other non-infectious dermatosis are pruritis, prurigo nodularis, and insect bite reaction. Coming to the post-exposure prophylaxis, as we are healthcare professionals, we are frequently encountered with blood pruritus, which often the patient is non-tested for HIV. In that case, we don't need to panic. If you know the post-exposure prophylaxis, this picture showing that there was a time gap between 48 to 72 hours from generalized dissemination of HIV from the lymph node. So if you suspect the person is of highly infective and the test came positive as HIV, we can start the treatment as immediately as possible within 48 to 72 hours. We can cure from the HIV. As the minimum time gap is 48 hours for the HIV from transfer to lymph nodes to the established infection. Based on the risk factors, two drug regimen or a three drug regimen have to be taken. Whether it is of non-intact skin, small volume drops are considered two drug therapy, two drug post-exposure prophylaxis. When it is a large major blood splash, we have to think of three drug post-exposure prophylaxis. The basic two drug regimens are NRTA. The most commonly used is the tenofovir with lamivudine or stavudine with emtricitabine. An expanded regimen where we can use for where the protease inhibitors are added. We have to check the baseline monitoring of CBC, LFT whenever the drugs are given. As the gedatolisib is as bone marrow suppressor drug, it may lead to anemia. Nevirapine is not generally preferred because of risk of hyperprotoxicity and hypersensitivity. Thank you. It is well said that when we know HIV, we can know the whole medicine. It is absolutely correct. These much infections are not common in any disease. Bacterial, viral, fungal, protozoan, everything, and whole immunology we can learn from the HIV treatment, HIV pathogen. Thank you.
Okay, very good, Suman. Okay, let's finish for today. I will inform you regarding Sumantha Nannu Adigaru for 1 week break. Ani, I will discuss today and inform you.
Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Hello, ma'am.
Cheppu Teja.
Ma'am, mari repo NTR University online class kuda undi, ma'am. Rep morning. Okasari inform cheddaman, ma'am.
Okay, aithe rep aithe evaru cheyadandi. You join that class.
Okay, ma'am.
Day after tomorrow, గురించి మట్టుకి నేను ఇవాల ఒక్కసారి అందరితో డిస్కస్ చేసి ఏమంటారు కనుక్కొని చెప్తాను.
ఓకే మ్యామ్. ఓకే మ్యామ్.
అంటే సార్ ఉంటే కుదరదని నేను ఓకే చెప్పలేదు. వాళ్ళని చూసి చెప్తాను. ఓకేనా?
ఓకే మ్యామ్. థాంక్యూ మ్యామ్.